Scientists at EPFL's Swiss Plasma Center and DeepMind have jointly developed a new method for controlling plasma configurations for use in nuclear fusion research. EPFL's Swiss Plasma Center SPC has decades of experience in plasma physics and plasma control methods. DeepMind is a scientific discovery company acquired by Google in 2014 that is committed to solving intelligence to advance science and humanity. Together, they have developed a new magnetic control method for plasmas based on deep reinforcement learning and applied it to a real-world plasma for the first time in the SPC's Tokamak Research Facility, TCV. The study has just been published in the journal Nature. Tokamaks are donut-shaped devices for conducting research on nuclear fusion, and the SPC is one of the few research centers in the world that has one in operation. These devices use a powerful magnetic field to confine plasma at extremely high temperatures, hundreds of millions of degrees Celsius, even hotter than the sun's core, so that nuclear fusion can occur between hydrogen atoms. The energy released from fusion is being studied for use in generating electricity. What makes the SPC's tokamak unique is that it allows for a variety of plasma configurations, hence its name, Variable Configuration Tokamak, TCV. That means scientists can use it to investigate new approaches for confining and controlling plasmas. A plasma's configuration relates to its shape and position in the device. Tokamaks form and maintain plasmas through a series of magnetic coils whose settings, especially voltage, must be controlled carefully. Otherwise, the plasma could collide with the vessel walls and deteriorate. To prevent this from happening, researchers at the SPC first test their control system's configuration on a simulator before using them in the TCV tokamak. DeepMind's experts developed an AI algorithm that can create and maintain specific plasma configurations and trained it on the SPC's simulator. This involved first having the algorithm try many different control strategies in simulation and gathering experience. Based on the collected experience, the algorithm generated a control strategy to produce the requested plasma configuration. This involved first having the algorithm run through a number of different settings and analyze the plasma configurations that resulted from each one. Then the algorithm was called on to work the other way to produce a specific plasma configuration by identifying the right settings. After being trained, the AI-based system was able to create and maintain a wide range of plasma shapes and advanced configurations, including one where two separate plasmas are maintained simultaneously in the vessel. Finally, the research team tested their new system directly on the tokamak to see how it would perform under real-world conditions.